I certainly did not see myself as someone who would use marijuana as medicine, but then I tried it and realized that marijuana works.
Medicam, a prescription for change.
Hi, I'm Javon Jackson, and welcome to Amsterdam. If you have questions about medical cannabis or your needs, come on in. I'll answer them.
Nug Magazine, San Diego's original cannabis publication. Always free of charge or subscribe at www.nugmag.com.
Green Cross Cooperative. Steps from the Sand on Mission Boulevard, the Beach City's premier in quality, selection, and pricing. With plenty of additional parking, two blocks north off El Carmel on Mission Bay.
Medical cannabis has become the leading alternative in healthcare for many Californians. Here at MC Square, we show that we care by offering the lowest cost recommendations, knowledgeable staff to answer your questions, a compassionate doctor, and a convenient location.
Welcome back. Cannabis can be used as an industrial tool in the form of hemp products, and there are literally hundreds of uses.
Let's take a look at this next segment.
Long ago, when these ancient Grecian temples were new, hemp was already old in the service of mankind. For thousands of years, even then, this plant had been grown for cordage and coarse cloth in China and elsewhere in the East. For centuries prior to about 1850, all the ships that sailed the Western seas were rigged with hempen rope and sails. For the sailor, no less than the hangman, hemp was indispensable. The Conestoga wagons and ferris schooners of pioneer days were covered with hempen canvas. Indeed, the very word canvas comes from the Arabic word for hemp. In the old days, breaking was done by hand, one of the hardest jobs known to man. Now, the power breaker makes quick work of it.
The hemp industry can now recover 95% of the fibers, rather than the 25 to 50% as before.
In 1935, Henry Ford's desire to unite industry and agriculture would lead to the formation of the Farm Commergic Council. The Commergic model would use the country's farmers to supply the industrial needs of the 20th century. The expanded markets would bolster the dismal state of affairs on American farms and ease the emerging problems of petrochemical pollution. Ford and the Council would find support in the like-minded genius of Thomas Edison and plant geneticists George Washington Carver and Luther Burbank. In 1938, advances in hemp decorticacion equipment prompted Popular Mechanics magazine to call hemp the billion-dollar crop with 25,000 uses. The development sprouted a new kind of hemp industry in Minnesota, one poised to exploit the cellulose-rich herds for use in the plastics industry. In 1916, the Department of Agriculture published Bulletin 404, written by Leister Dewey and plant and paper chemist Jason Merrill. Printed on hemp paper, the bulletin warned that forests cannot withstand the demands and praised the paper potential of hemp. Henry Ford had a vision of growing automobiles from the soil. At the company's River Rouge plant, researchers used annual crops to develop biodegradable car parts, and in 1941 unveiled a car whose plastic body was made entirely from hemp, wheat straw, and sisal. The bioplastic withstood blows 10 times as great as steel without denting, and its reduced weight promised better fuel efficiency.
1937 was my first summer to spend with my grandfather. And at that time, they grew hemp to make rope. And him and the next farmer had a machine, and you made your threads, okay? After you had it on the spools, then you would go and make rope. But then in the latter years of the Depression, they banned it. It was banned by the government of North America. It came at just when the Depression was right at its worst, about 1937. The law was passed that it was illegal to have hemp seed. It was illegal to have it, and it was illegal to grow it. It was actually illegal to have hemp seed in your possession. It was stopped being used by Mackenzie King. And I would listen to the old timers, my Uncle Bill and my grandpa and Fred Wagner and those people talking. Like, they really felt that they had been hard done by.
In 1942, in a full reversal, the U.S. Department of Agriculture presented the movie Hemp for Victory, encouraging farmers to grow hemp.
The hemp industry was in decline when the United States entered World War II, with a nation's supply of Manila hemp and jute curtailed by the Japanese invasion of the Philippines. The government turned to the farmers for help. The War Hemp Industries built 42 mills throughout the Midwest. Hemp production rose dramatically as the nation's farmers produced 60 million pounds of fiber for the country's supply of cordage.
But then they banned it. It was banned by the government of North America.
In the waning years of the 20th century, the Earth's most useful crop re-emerged on farms the world over. For more than half a century, hemp was a crop in exile.
To bring into the world 200 million new people a year, that nearly equal to the population of the United States, and to not want to bring in a source of shelter and clothing and food is virtually irresponsible.
Here at Nature's RX, we provide over 20 different strains of nature's best medication. We have a wide variety of delicious edibles. We're centrally located in San Diego, open 7 days a week.
Please come and see us. Medicating is not a crime. Thank you.
I certainly didn't think that I was the type of person to use marijuana as medicine until I did, and I realized that marijuana works.
Medican, a prescription for change.
Victory 215 provides safe access to medical cannabis. Discounts for seniors, veterans, and college students. Located at 1025 West Lower Street in San Diego.
Downtown Kush Lounge Cooperative.
We're conveniently located in downtown San Diego.
Steps outside of the gas lamp. Killer meds, tons of choices.
These guys get it. Downtown Kush Lounge Cooperative.
Cross Cooperative. Steps from the Sand on Mission Boulevard, the Beach City's premier in quality, selection, and pricing. With plenty of additional parking, two blocks north off El Carmel on Mission Bay.
By Advanced Nutrients.
Welcome back. You just saw and were perhaps surprised that cannabis has some incredible industrial applications as hemp. Well, cannabis is also a very powerful medicine, as you are about to see in this next patient testimonial.
I have several illnesses that come under a category called autoimmune disease. If marijuana became available or usable without a legal issue for me, then I would use it, I believe, the same way that I did in Amsterdam, which is at night before I go to bed, so I can sleep through the night without being disturbed by pain, and as a result of that, have sufficient stamina during the day not to need to take these narcotic medications.